So communication skills, we said, is essential if you are, because the entire business of recruitment is dependent on communication. If communication skills doesn't mean only verbal communication, it also includes written communication. When you're writing a mail to a client, your English should be proper, otherwise it will send out very wrong signal. So generally communication, that's why I said reading habits are important. The more material you have inside you, the more effective you will be. Then only you should have something inside to be able to speak to people. Right? So that's why this knowledge is very important. So keep building your knowledge base. So communication skills is one. Then go to second slide. Be clear and concise. Right? So clarity of thought. Think through your ideas and rehearse your speech in advance. Vary your tone, pace, volume, this, that. Stay on the topic. So if you're talking on a particular topic, stick to that topic. Use plain English. We had somebody who had worked in call center. So when he came, he was using call center English. You know, call center English is that? English of? USA. I said, look, you are not in call center. Let us speak in a plain, simple English. English is not to show to anybody anything. It is just a tool to communicate our, the state. So, plain, simple English. So clarity of thought, be clear and concise. So you check, are you clear and concise when you speak to somebody? You finish your discussion in one sentence or 20 seconds, right? So when you're talking to candidate or client, this is important. Active listening, are you listening, or while you're listening, there are thoughts going on in your mind? So are you a good listener? As a recruiter, this is also important. When client is also going to call you, candidates are also going to call you, you have to listen to them and understand what is that they want. Next slide. Empathy. Being open to the idea of others and sensitive to the values and feelings. Meaning with candidate, client, or with your team members, with your colleagues, with even outside people who are coming to office, we should be sensitive to everybody. We should not shout. We should avoid shouting at each other, or we should be a little, humble in talking to the person. You can always raise your tone after 10th or 11th time, right? Not right at the beginning. Oh, you are not doing this, that. So, all of us sometimes lose our temper, right? Including me. I may be saying this, but then I also lose my temper sometimes. But then you should also have the ability to hold your temper, and then if you have hurt somebody, you should also have that relationship with that person to call that person and mend your ways. Hey, look, I was not in my original self, so I told you this, I am extremely sorry. So there is a very good word in English dictionary, right, which is luckily given. Use it freely. Don't be miser in using sorry. Sorry to candidate, sorry to client. The moment you say sorry, half of his temper is gone. Right? Questioning and gathering information. Now this is basically quality of inquisitiveness. How inquisitive you are. Are you always interested in knowing more about everything? Whether about yourself, about people, about society, about industry, about what job you have in hand, your clients, candidates. Are you inquisitive to know more?
Yes.
Recruiters, successful recruiters have this quality very much there. They're always keen to know more and more and more and more. So check whether you are inquisitive or not. Confirm and clarify. Meaning, before arriving at anything, any decision or any view on anything, always confirm. Don't have prejudice. Don't be, you know, don't have preconceived notions. Right? So, confirm and clarify. So, be clear about what all information is required for the discussion. Ask clarifying questions. How, why, who, what, where. Summarize the key points. Suppose you are going to meet a client and he is going to give you a big project. Be clear about everything. Note down what is needed in that project, how it is to be done, who will be doing it at your place, what kind of team you have, how you will allocate work. All that has to be distinct. Next slide. Jargon-free language. Simple words, we discussed also. Something which we can, which anybody, even a layman with average understanding can understand your thing. Assertiveness. There is a thin line between aggression and assertiveness. So don't be aggressive, but always be assertive. Correct? Meaning, if somebody is wrong, you can always be assertive in telling him, no, look, this is not right. Don't then try to wriggle out of the situation. Be assertive. Be assertive with your client. Be assertive with your candidates. Be assertive with yourself, with your team, everybody. Right? Appreciation. So, as recruiter, do we appreciate people around us or not? Suppose a candidate has helped you giving some references. Do you thank him? Thanks a lot. I'm really thankful to you to help me in this. Or you feel it is below your dignity to, some people are wrong, why should I say thanks to this, that, right? So once you appreciate, our positive energy increases. You encourage, say thanks, greetings and wishes. These are ways in which you can actually have a better energy wherever you are. So this applies to all aspects of recruitment. So just check whether you appreciate people or not. First of all, whether you appreciate yourself or not. And then others. Writing. Now, we have to also understand one thing. Candidate could be in age or whatever, very senior to you. But we should never use sir, you know, to candidate. It is not that we have any problem in that. But you have to also understand, you as a recruiter, you have to also have certain your own self sort of worth. You cannot be, because ultimately you are not working under a candidate or a client. So always address your candidates as Mr. or Mrs. or Miss. Always. The moment you do that, you are at par with that person. The moment you say sir, your sir becomes like this.
I had done.
Right?
Once I had done, then I had this problem.
Now if you say Hina madam, so automatically she actually will become madam. Right? So I mean we should always deal with people at par. There is no need to be whatever position you are, doesn't matter. Always self-respect should be